This is Snoopy.
I was just a wee little lad, full of health and joy. My father homeward came one night, gave to me a toy. A wonder to behold it was, with many colors bright. And the moment I laid eyes on it, became my heart's delight. It went zip when it moved, and when it stopped, whirred when it stood still. I never knew just what it was, and I guess I'll never try it with me. It went zip when it moved, and when it stopped, whirred when it stood still. I never knew just what it was, and I guess I'm a little more bravely than that, because that's not going to get us what we want in the world. We have to show a little more heart and determination. It went zip when it moved, and when it stopped, and when it stood, that's good. I never knew just what it was, and I guess I never will. The first time that I picked it up, I had a big surprise. Cause right on the bottom were two big buttons that looked like big green eyes. I first pushed one, and then the other with me. Come on, everybody. And then I twisted its lid. Help me. Keep helping me. When I set it down again, here is what it did. It went zip when it moved, and when it stopped, and when it stood still. I never knew just what it was, and I guess I never. I think you've got the singing down. The sounds lack a little something. The first sound is no, my zip is not your zip. We know that for years. But your zip can be a special zip as well. But we should all start with zip, and then the after effects of having done that, let it flow through you. Zip! All right, let's try it. One, two, three. Zip! You got it. The second sound. Second sound. Please don't face anybody more than 2 feet away from you. Less than 2 feet away from you, because it could be a dangerous act. Not necessarily of aggression, but passive aggression. Oh, terribly sorry. No good. Practice if you don't know how to do by putting your hand in front of your mouth. And for those of you who are young, when the teacher asks you, Sam, have you done your homework? You can go. Don't take me seriously. Here we go. Everybody, one, two, three. That was, first of all, discombobulated. It was, in a word, imperfect. Can we, in this lifetime, do a perfect... But more important, in this lifetime, can we do a perfect group... Let me lecture to you on the subtleties of a group. Many people like to in private. Some people like to in twos. But the vast majority of people that I know would like the coverage of anonymity when they. So can we try it together And know, in years to come when we speak of this, and we shall, we shall be kind to one another. I feel the delight and the enthusiasm for... Here we go, one, two, three. That was disgusting. And the last sound is... Can you do it with your hands too? All right, here we go. It first marched left with me. With me. Left. Right. And then marched under red shed. And when I looked where it had gone, it wasn't even there. I started to cry. But my daddy laughed. Because he knew that I would find, when I turned around, my marvelous toy would be chugging from behind. It was going zip when it moved, and when it stopped, and when it stood still. I never knew just what it was. I guess I never will. The years have passed by too quickly, it seems. I haven't my own little girl and boy. Yesterday I gave to them my marvelous little toy. Their eyes nearly popped right out of their heads. And they gave a squeal of glee. None of us knows just what it is, but they love it just like me. It's still sick when it moves, and when it stops, and when it stands still. I never knew just what it was, and I guess I never... All right, now wait. I want you to do something. Because now we are together. In the very deepest of senses. We have sung together. We have booked together. And we have brrrred together. But there's something else that we could do. We could have an orchestra of brrrr. So, watch my hand. Okay, like that? Going from the... If you do a crescendo, that means it gets louder and louder. It goes to this side. Here we go. And back again. Again. Follow my hand. Back again. Follow my hand. Follow my hand. Follow my hand. Now let me do it with my head. Lost your way. The reason I wanted you to do this is that I don't think that Snoopy, although he's done a great deal in his life that's remarkable, has ever conducted an orchestra. An orchestra of brrrrs using his head in the most significant of ways. Snoopy will now conduct you, following Snoopy, if you please. Conducted a brilliant performance. Now you know the power of folk music. Doesn't that feel good? Wouldn't it be great for everybody to just say,
All I have to do is stand on the stage and go. Then we could march on the administration building. The problem being that we are in the administration. We didn't used to be. So it's useless. We'll be marching on our own offices and homes. Okay. Last. It went zip when it moves and when it stops it. And it stood still and never knew just what it was. It's not it. And never knew just what it was. Yes, I never will. Bravo, bravo, bravissimo. Where's my capo? Bravissimo, bravissimo capo. Capo candomare, manda sacchilona, isci battitori, occhi botti romma, scalla patanda, schitti dalle dai. It's right on my stool. It's right on my stool. Right where I... Now, I would like to introduce to you my friend, a very gifted musician, creator. The complexity of his machines makes the marvelous toy look like the beginning. Whereas this is somewhere in the middle. Please, without further ado, or maybe a little further ado, but not too much further, please welcome to the stage my co-performer for the evening, Snoopy Bottom. Give him a huge hand.
Thank you, Peter. I wanted to take a minute and say something before I do the song. As some of you may know, I program communication devices to sing. I do this in many different voices, both male and female. This allows any person, young or old, to sing. The song that Peter and I are doing tonight, I did in a female voice. I did it that way because Mary was the lead singer in this song. And also because I try to program songs for both males and females. Peter, Paul, and Mary, I am sure, have touched all of us with their music. And tonight I'm sure that Mary is with us in spirit. Their music has inspired me to reach my potential, and as I sing this song, may it inspire you to reach yours.
Shoo, shoo, shoo.
Snoopy, you do great work. It's a beautiful thing. We were talking late about how Snoopy might interface with the program called the Don't Laugh at Me program. Remember, that's the one you can get free from OperationRespect.org with all those songs that you can download. And if you don't know that, get out your pens and write OperationRespect.org, because free is always good in this economy. Okay, now Snoop, you want to stay on stage for the rest?
Yeah.
All right, here we go. What I thought we could do...
What I thought we could do... Did I tell you what I thought we could do? I thought we could do a tribute to Mary.
I'll tell you, you'll enjoy that more than my Catskill Mountain Jewish. I'm telling you, listen to me, mister. Because that's a slightly more annoying persona that I channel from time to time, and I'd like to prevent myself from doing that. So if I do start to slip into that mood, would you just say, sing the song, Peter? Can you do that with me? Sing the song, Peter. Again,
sing the song, Peter.
Oh, I love the sound of that. All right, here we go. Now, at Mary's celebration, memorial celebration, we sang this song, Noel and I, and we asked the audience to do Mary's part. And to a large degree, that's what happened, and quite beautifully so. So in a sense, we began by saying, in an active way, she is with us. She always had a very strong voice, but this was pushing it a bit. We used to say she could overload not just a microphone, but a copper wire. And it was a night filled with beauty, fun. Snoop, you okay, or are you just enthusiastic? Brother. All right, we're working the room, Snoop. Here we go. You know what I was going to ask you? You were wearing that hat earlier?
What?
Were you wearing a hat earlier today?
Oh, yeah, the green hat. I was going to help my mom sell graphics.
Right. Because I was thinking, I wanted you on the stage. Tonight I'm going to need you on the stage. Say what? To sing Puff the Magic Dragon. With others. All my bags are packed, I'm ready.
ready to go. I'm standing here outside your door. I hate to wake you up to say goodbye, but the dawn is breaking, it's early morn. The taxi's waiting, he's blowing his horn. Already I'm so lonesome I could cry. So kiss me and smile for me. Tell me that you'll wait for me. Hold me like you'll never let me go. 'Cause I'm leaving on a jet plane. Don't know when I'll be back again. This is really a good song for you to, if you courted to this song, now they say dated. How did such a benign word become so impactful and powerful? If you courted to this song and you are here with that person, take that person's hand, hold it in yours with heart and love. If you're with somebody else, look at them, shrug and say, I love you, honey, and take that person's hand. If you're sitting next to somebody you're finding somewhat attractive, you may take this occasion to introduce yourself. And years from now, when you speak of this, and you will, you say, we met at that wonderful conference where you sang, and I took her hand, and she took mine, and now we're married. We've been divorced 3 times, but we keep on remarrying. Okay, here we go, here we go. I want to see everybody. If it's your child, if it's your friend, if it's your buddy, if it's a little stuffed animal next to you that you're particularly fond of, take its hand. If you don't have anybody, take your own hand. I know I could be arrested for making such a suggestion. So many times I've let you down. So many times I've played around. I'll tell you now, they don't mean a thing. Every place I go, I'll think of you. Every song I'll sing. I like this. Look, look over here. I'm talking, look. Look over here, what we got here. They got the little spinky and the pinky going back and forth. Everybody else take a spinky pinky from them and start going back and forth. Here we go. There's so many times I've let you down. So many times I've played around. I'll tell you now that they don't mean a thing. Every place I go, I think Mary's turning over. Every song I sing, I'll sing for you. When I come back, I'll wear your wedding. Okay, swinky pinky, have you? Kiss me and smile for me. Tell me that you'll wait for me. Hold me like you'll never let me go. Don't know when I'll be back again. Oh, babe, I hate to go. Now the time has come to leave you. One more time, let me kiss you. Close your eyes. I'll be on my way. Dream about the days to come when I won't have to leave alone. About the times I won't have to say.
Kiss me and smile for me. Tell me that you'll wait for me.
Hold me like you'll never let me go. All right, how many of you want to hear my colonoscopy song? I only remember some of the words, but I'll make them up, the rest of them up. Although it could get a little gross. Let me see. How many of you did not know that I had written a colonoscopy song? Raise your hands. How many of you did know? Raise your hands. It's filtering through. And please don't take that the wrong way. So, let me see. What did I do? This is National Colorectal Cancer Colonoscopy Rectal. Is that where they got Rectify? Awareness Month. Now, I've heard of wonderful awareness months, but this one, I think, is the most intense. The reason that I said yes to this is that, you know, Mary was taken, not by cancer, but by the effects of the chemotherapy that prepared her for a successful bone marrow transplant. So in a sense, the fact that she got cancer and had to have the chemotherapy, which causes inflammations in the lungs in some patients, ultimately was what took her life. But if anybody asked me to be a part of any effort to defeat cancer, or for that matter, make the world a better place, I mean, after all these years, what, am I going to change my habits? No. Now, that doesn't mean that you can say, Peter, you need to sing at my son's bar mitzvah. It's not going to happen. I mean, I am available to a certain degree for certain things, and certainly for colorectal cancer and for colonoscopies. Let me see. All right, please, this is a very serious song. Very serious song now. This is about cancer. Colon. When I had my colonoscopy, I had a question on my mind. Do we all look the same when the doctor sees us from behind? Then I have the answer. I felt like such a fool, 'cause the doctor smiled and said to me, your colon's really cool. My colon's really cool. What a nice surprise. The
doctor sees a lot of colons, but my colon took the prize. Then he told me something that was even more divine. He said, "We found a polyp hiding, Peter, but we caught it just in time. We found a polyp hiding. Don't mean to be so crass, but the polyp was discovered by a camera up your mother. And your polyp spoke to me that very day. They said, 'Son, you've won the polyp prize. Hooray, 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 hooray.'" And that's all I remember. You've heard the shank of it, but you haven't heard the butt of it yet. And the interesting thing is that this whole campaign by CBS really is all humorous and poking fun. And I got wonderful, it's up, go to Kolonowski's song, Peter Yarrow. Frankly, I'm the only little worried because the popularity has spread so rapidly that when they write my obituary, they say, "Somewhat known for Puff the Magic Dragon and his activism for human rights and social justice, Peter's greatest work was the colonoscopy song." Save us from that. I want to do something. I want to go on a boat ride. Who here wants to go with me? Who trusts me enough to want to go on a boat ride? No, boat. Now, the important thing to remember on this boat ride is that it doesn't have a motor. We are dependent upon the wind. And as it is with Pete Seeger's sloop, you know, on the Hudson of the Clearwater, it was dependent upon the wind. And as with Pete Seeger, our idea is we're going to go from one country to the next. And wherever we land, as the sloop did, we'll sing. We'll dispense with the colonoscopy song, certainly, but we have other songs to sing together. And the people, they will rejoice, for it is a good thing. And they will see it as a good thing. It will be written in their book. And the king will rejoice, and so will the queen. And she will say to the king, "It is a good thing," and he will agree with her. And it will be not the first time that he has agreed with her. And so it will be, together we will do a good thing. And then they will say, "What is the purpose of your trip?" "Yo," we shall say. "Yo, our trip is about spreading the gospel of weeness." Weeness? Yes, not Eunice, not meanness, weeness. Togetherness. But in contemporary terms, weeness. That means we're all together. And when we're together, we're less likely, by far, to make fun of each other. We have fun together. But we don't make fun of each other, do we? And no, cha 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 cha. So, that's what our mission is. Let's get on the boat. Everybody, get ready. Get into your seats. You are in your seats. You're prepared for this trip. All right, here we go. The stream sings it to the river, and the river sings it to the sea, and the sea sings it to the boat that carries you and me. Somos el barco, somos el barco.
Selma. Yo navego en ti, tú navegas en mí. We are the boat, we are the sea. We are the sea. I sail in you, I sail in you. You sail in me, you sail in me. Once again, we are the boat. We are the boat. We are the sea. We are the sea. I sail in you. I sail in you. You sail in me. You sail in me. Now this ship we are sailing on was built by many hands, and the sea we are sailing on, it touches many lands. Somos el barco, somos el mar, somos el mar. Yo navego en ti, yo navego en ti. Tú navegas en mí, tú navegas en mí. We are the boat, we are the boat. I sail in you, you sail in me, you sail in me. They were going on along at quite a clip and everybody's feeling really confident. We've decided to do this together and the sails are just carrying us forward, and all of a sudden we are becalmed. It is a terrible, terrible thing that we are becalmed. And the captain, who looks at the map, says, oh no, this is the point of becalmed. It surrounds a rock that is mythological in its power, and it calms the winds for a quarter of a mile in every direction. We cannot go forward. We have to get out of here. How will we do it? And the first mate pipes up with the answer, Captain, we have the paddles. We can pass out the paddles, and we can row. We can paddle and row and get there. We don't need the wind for a quarter of a mile, Captain. He said, yes, but who will pass out the paddles? Well, I know who will pass out the paddles.
I'll get them, and I need all the kids who are here to pass them out.
That's what the first thing I need. Come on up to here.
Can you handle 16 paddles? Okay. Raise your hands if you need a paddle. Go give them the paddles. Okay. Can you handle 10 paddles?
Depends on how they fail.
Okay, go ahead. Raise your hands if you need a paddle. Okay, put your arms up. Here. Okay, raise your hands if you need a paddle. Everybody come on up. Can you handle 16 paddles?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, raise your hands if you need a paddle. Anybody who needs a paddle, raise your hand. Thank you.
needs a paddle over there, quickly, or be calm.
All right, anybody else need a paddle? Okay, all right, everybody with me, on your, it's my right, it's your left, okay, so it's this side, you start, like this, lift it up carefully, don't hit the person next to you, and then like that, lift it up carefully, like this, and then like that, I want it. If somebody isn't paddling, it's not going to work. I didn't tell you that part, but we've all got to paddle. It's like democracy. Here we go. We. We are the bold. Here we go. Watch. Again. Ready? On your left, my right. We are the boat. Here we go, on the left. We are the sea. Dig in, and we're not moving yet. I sail in you. Even deeper. You sail in me. Dig in deeper. We are the boat. Come on, let's do it. We're beginning to move. I sail in you, I sail in you. You sail in me, keeping. We are the bow. Come on, dig. We are the sea. We're moving. I sail in you. You sail in me. We are the boat. We are the boat, singing it out. We are the sea. That's how we keep in time. I sail in you. You sail in me. You sail in me. We're really going fast now. We are the boat. We're doing it, folks. We are the sea. I feel the wind. I sail in you. You sail in. Okay, let the wind take over. Put your paddles in your laps. With our hearts we set the sail. Face the seas once more. With our hopes we chart the waters. Never sailed before. Somos el barco. Somos el mar. Somos el mar. You know they go in deep. Tu navego en ti, tu navegas en mí, tu navegas en mí. We are the boat. We are the boat. We are the sea. You feel the wind. I sail in you. There's the shore. You sail in me. One more time. We are the boat. There are people to greet us. We are the sea. I sail in you. I sail in you. Ah, we're going to land. You sail in me. That's how we do it. That was terrific. That was a great journey. And you know, I've done this a couple of times before where I really felt that we were really moving. I'll tell you, you know, these placebo pills, they work. So, now what did I do with my... Oh my goodness, I got my capo, but I lost my thumbtick. At least for one moment. Aha! Here it is. All right. Now, what I wanted to say is that singing together like this and being able to transcend the boundaries of age, background, perspective, need systems, travail of many sorts, is the building block of creating a new future for all of humanity. I mentioned this morning for some of you that we're here, that the pyramid of hate is really descriptive of the genesis of the big problems in the world. Most of them are caused, if they are caused by human beings, are generated by the presence or absence of respect. You will ask yourself, why did we march in the 60s? And I spoke about that this morning. We marched because the mother of all these movements, and I was just there in Montgomery, Selma, in a recap of the march from Selma to Montgomery. We started in Birmingham with a church with the four children, little girls that were killed by a bomber that bombed the church. And it was very painful, but it was good that I was there, because there weren't any singers there that were used to leading. And I was able to sing together with everybody and recognize that when we could feel close in times of despair, in times of joy, in times of hope, in times of struggle, we empower each other in such a way that there's a certain clarity about what it is that we're experiencing, and we can articulate goals and move together. And we did that in the civil rights movement. And one of the reasons that I answer people when they say, why are the kids not out there demonstrating? Well, they don't feel united. And one of the ways in which we got to feel united was by singing together, because that didn't just unite us in terms of singing, united our hearts, and let us know in our hearts that we were committed to something, which is what we just experienced. Better to do it first with you and then tell you, look at it this way. That's the kind of connection that classrooms and students need. And I'm talking about classrooms with black students, Hispanic students, Caucasian students. I'm talking about Muslim, Jewish, Christian, atheist students. I'm talking about students with extraordinary skills like Snoopy, and kids who wouldn't even dream of trying to do that, but they have other gifts. We are all gifted. The first gift that we have is one of the ability to bestow a sense of love. To me, that's the primary gift we all have. And if we're allowed to evolve in such a way that that gift evolves, other gifts will follow. If we're not allowed to evolve in that way, then the other gifts that we have will be suppressed. So we have to look as activists for the community with disabilities and the rights of young people to get equitable access to education so that they can do the kind of extraordinary things that Snoop is doing here. We have to not think of this group with special needs as being against the rest of the world. There was a time when that was the perception. But ultimately, what worked in the movement was inspiration, was nonviolence, and love. And in the anti-war movement, for instance, I would say that those who chose a violent course inhibited the progress of ending the war. I think we have the right to be outraged, but we don't have the mandate, either from an ethical point of view or from a tactical point of view, to be outrageous in response to something that we find outrageous. Inequality and injustice is an outrage, but if we act in an outrageous fashion, we simply allow the genesis of the problem to set the playing field and become party to that evolution. If you didn't follow that, come to my hotel room in 2 hours and there will be a very clear explanation. Basically, what I am saying is that we have to hold our ground as moral human beings, as loving human beings, and learn from those movements. The civil rights movement, as I said, is about racism, a very virulent form of disrespect. Inequity. Justice shalt thou pursue. What about the women's movement? That's about fairness and respect vis-a-vis women in society who could not enjoy just equity with men, males, and still do not, although great progress has been made. In what areas was there not equity? Pardon? Pay, that's right. Pay, what else? Education, voting rights, you got it.
Reproductive rights.
That, which is more a matter of saying rights to the body. Right? Men are allowed to make all those choices. So, what about the environmental movement? How is that about the absence or presence of respect? Respect for what? Pardon me? The Mother Earth? Trees? The future, the next generation. And that's about greed. So greed and inequity are very closely linked. So, our resources, yes. Depletion and the next generation, right. So with that in mind, we have to look at our task together as advocates as not being exclusionary. If you want to stick up for the rights of Jews in the Anti-Defamation League, you got to stick up for everybody's rights. Everybody. Or you're not going to do it. If you're going to say we are advocates for the disability community because our kids are not getting what they deserve, fine, but your heart has to be in resonance with other segments of society that are also not given a fair shake. And if we don't have that, then we become meanness rather than usness. I like usness better than weeness. But it's just an aesthetic choice. That's right. So, in the spirit of usness, let me tell you a story. One of my best friends was a quadriplegic. He passed away. He got a live shot of polio vaccine when he was 5 years old. And I knew him when I was living in California because he did a folk show. He, like you, oh my goodness, Snoop, look what I have done again. Like you, Snoop, he was way ahead of the curve. He was paralyzed from the neck down, but very brilliant. He was in an iron lung for 2 years. He got a live shot of the sock vaccine by accident, of course. And he grew up and he got an MA in Italian and Spanish, and then he loved folk music. So he had a folk music called Malibu something. I've forgotten what the name of the show was. But I did the show a few times and we became friendly. And then it came to a point where rehab was not going to provide him with... See, he won a huge case, but they didn't expect him to live beyond, you know, the most optimistic projection would be that he lived 20 years. So the settlement only included support for the 20 years. And after that, he was pretty much fending for himself. He was represented by a very famous attorney, F. Lee Bailey. Well, in any event, he was now past that point. He was past 20 years. And he needed another van so that he could go and do his show and everything like that. And I went to one of the members of the state legislature, who is now the head of the foreign relations in the Congress, Howard Berman, who was the head of the district. I was living out there, and I said, I need help for this, for my friend, Brian May. So he did what he could, and then I did some benefit concerts, and then we got him that truck, and so we were in this. So I talked to him just about every day, even after I went back to New York. And at a certain point, he was given the Medal of Honor by the White House. And he was the only recipient who could not make it because traveling was too dangerous for him, even though they got a private corporate plane to take him from L.A. To Washington, D.C. So he said to me, Peter, I need for you to receive this on my behalf and sing the song that I love to sing with you, that I'm going to sing with you now, which is a song of courage of somebody who was struggling with cancer, but it applies to all of us. Now, my problem was this was during Bush 1. And I mean, I loved my friend very much, but this was asking a lot of me. I mean, I never in my wildest dream thought there might be a Bush 2. Yes, I am a dyed-in-the-wool Republican. Actually, I think if we sing together, these distinctions will melt, as I will presently tell you. So there I went, dressed in my black tie and nothing else, which was my statement. And I met the First Lady, and she was gracious. And I was so angry because of what was going on that I for a while, I couldn't even see. And then I sat there and watched, and I saw the greatest group of people, all involved in supporting these people who are getting the Medals of Honor. And my friend, Brian May. And I said, wait a second. There is common ground. It was my first experience in hostile territory of that sort. And I learned a big lesson. The same lesson that Mary Travers learned when she first spoke to her donor, her donor for her bone marrow transplant, who after a year was allowed to talk to her, and she got on the phone and she said, "Hi, I'm Mary Travers," and she said, "Hi, I'm Mary." She said, "Your name is Mary too?" She said, "Yes." She said, "Are you a mother?" "Yes." "Do you have children?" "Yes, I have two children." "I have two children." She said, "This is phenomenal." How incredible," she said. "I must tell you, I had the most terrible nightmare. I had a nightmare that I was in a voting booth after having, this is by the way, after all her white cells were her donor cells, and she had no leukemic cells in her body. So she was, for all intents and purposes, cured of cancer. But she went to the voting booth, she said, in the nightmare, and she went to pull her lever, and her hand, like Dr. Strangelove, went over there and pulled the wrong lever. And she said, "Oh my God, it must be my white cells. I had this terrible nightmare that you were a Republican." There was silence on the other end of the phone. And then after a few moments, the words, "But Mary, I am a Republican." So, saying this is for all of us, and it took me a long time to get here, here is the song I sing again from my brother, Brian May, who passed away when he was 40, twice as long as he was supposed to live. He was sunshine in my life. We had the most wonderful times. And I miss him dearly. But I can think of the brightness of what we shared and sing this song. It has a chorus. Wouldn't you know that you're being invited to sing? With your face to the wind, I see you smiling again. Spirits moving within. I know that you're gonna win. And you've been down this road before. Something inside tells you what's in store. You gotta remember what we're all here for. You gotta eat up the apple and spit out the core. With your face to the wind, with your face to the wind, I see you smiling again, I see you smiling again. Spirits moving within, spirits moving within. I know that you're gonna win, I know that you're gonna win. You can get angry, and you can curse. You can shout it out in rhyme or verse. You can tell me that it's never been worse. Then take that old sow's ear and turn it into a purse. With your face to the wind, with your face to the wind. Smiling, I see you smiling again. Spirits moving within. Spirits moving within. I know that you're gonna win. I know that you're gonna win. There are gifts that come like the rain. They make the plants grow, but they drench you all the same. There are gifts that took you years to see, like the gift of the friend that you've been to me. And there are hands here to comfort you. If you need, there are tears to cry with you too. There hear hearts that will sing with you, and voices to cheer. When you finally made it through with your face to the wind, with your face to the wind. I see you smiling, I see you smiling again. Spirits moving, spirits moving within. I know that you're gonna win, I know that you're gonna win. By this time, I had all of the Kennedy Center singing with me. We started with a projected image of Brian May and me singing together. By the time we had finished, it was clear there were no Republicans or Democrats. There were just a bunch of caring people that were singing together, caring together. Sometimes it takes the dark to let you see the light. You can't have the victory unless you fought the fight. Sometimes it takes a winding road to lead us home. Why are you winding around, my friend? Just don't go winding round alone with your face to the wind. With your face to the wind. I see you smiling. I see you smiling again. Spirits moving within. Spirits moving within. I know you're gonna win. I know that you're gonna win. I know that you're gonna win. I know that you're gonna win. I know you're gonna win. I know that you're gonna win. So as we go forward together, singing and hoping, dreaming and working, we have to do it in the spirit of what it is we're trying to achieve. If we don't, we become bitter and hypocritical. It's a challenge. But the love that is at the basis of what we want to try and inculcate is the love that we have to regenerate in each other. And I think that it's time to sing Blowing in the Wind. But I can't do it alone anymore. I need to do it in Snoop. Can we ask Snoop to please do it? And Blowing in the Wind is an interesting song because it asks questions. And Mary would always point out that asking questions rather than not taking responsibility for figuring out what we want to do is kind of the kernel of participation in democracy. Am I doing the right thing? What are my choices? I'm going to find out if it's appropriate for me to take this position. As we look at healthcare, and we hope that we will make giant strides, we have to hope that the determination of what is done in this country is not going to be a reflection of ignorance. Ignorance due to people who have lost the impulse, the habit, and the essential capacity to ask questions. If they hear a label, it's socialistic, which condemns, of course, Medicare, which was opposed. My friends, asking questions is a sacred duty. As a member of a democracy, I want to ask questions, and I want to do it in this song with my brother Snoop. Snoop, would you play the song and let's do it together? Could you turn on that microphone, please, and bring it up? For the Magic Dragons to come in. Now look, this is an important thing. I want all the kids here to come and sit. I seldom make that sound, but I felt you deserved it. So can you... it's all good. Right, I'd like to have the following people. Any kids here, that means under 18 years old, a youth, a ute, chronologically. For you come up first. You have first dippies on the pippy. So you come up here and snip on the dip. Sit over here, that's right. Ba-da, ba-da. There, I knew you'd be up here in a moment. Come on up, on the stage, on the stage. Come on the stage. Now Okay, they are playing their games to get on stage, and they're doing it well. But please come on stage if you are younger than 18. If you are younger than 18 and not coming, come on over here, up the ramp, please. If you are younger than... That's right. If you're younger than 18 and you haven't come up here, I am. And I am a merciless tickler. I'm going to look amongst you and begin to search out. I think you must come on stage or you get tickled. Yes, right now. Now we want anybody who's younger than 25 who wanted to come sit down on the stage. Right, come around here. Just stand on the stage. Stand around me. Come on around. Come on around. Walk forward. Take three embarrassed steps forward. There you go. There you go. There you go. Now it's time for Facebook. All right, come farther back. Come farther back. Back, back. Back, back. Come back. Come back. That's right, come back here. That's right. But let Snoop retain his place in the cosmos. Right now, any of you of a certain age who ironed your hair hoping... that one day Mary would be hoarse. And you'd come and say, I know the words, I'll sing Mary's part. You too can come here. You have a place in the cosmos. No, you're going to have to endure it as I have for the past hour or so. Now, and if, yes, I know, that's what you have to endure. If you're going to be a performer, you have to deal with it. Now, you can close your eyes, you can sit on the floor, but the lights will persist. Now, is there anybody else here who has a craving or a need? Because you won't have another chance to sing Puff with me. Right. All right. All right. Come sit down on the stage. If you're standing in front of me, it doesn't work too well. Sitting down on the stage. That's right. Sitting down. Okay. I'm going to count to 10. By the time I've counted to 10, anybody... can think of yourselves as saying, darn, I had this opportunity to sing Puff the Magic Dragon with Puff's real daddy, and I turned it down. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, better hurry, eight, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Puff the Magic Dragon lived by the sea and frolicked.
Live by the sea.
dragon lived
by the sea and frolicked in the autumn mist in a land called Hungary.
Oh,
Puff the magic dragon lived by the sea.
Wow.
And frolicked in the autumn mist in a land called Hanami.
Yes! Wow. In 1963, which is a long time ago, 250,000 people got together and said, there is unfairness in our country. And we say, we all have the right to their life, liberty, and the pursuit. Yes. What? Okay. Now's your time. If you're, particularly if you're on Twitter, go for it.
I love you, all you. I love you.
I love everybody.
Hey, buddy.
We love you. Give me a hug. Well done. Well done. When we sang together 20 years ago, anybody else? You do? Okay, come on, sweetie. I love it, I love it.
I love you, Mom and Dad.
Yay! Okay. Anybody else have some final words to share? Yes, darling.
This is for my dad and my mom, too.
Yeah. Anybody else have some fun? You started something. You started something good. Yes, you have something to say?
Yes. Thank you for being with us.
No, thank you.
Hey, Ryan, I got front row tickets to the Phillies. Now who's the bigger fan, eh?
Hey, Maury. Meet me in back. I got another truckload.
So we sang, you know, we would like our country to be everything that it should be, but we've got a road to hoe. You know, African Americans, people of color, were not allowed to use the same drinking fountains in our nation's capital. They weren't allowed to use the same toilets as people who are Caucasian. And there were lynchings. And if you lived in the South, if you lived in the South, in Alabama or Mississippi, if you were almost without, you could be lynched and hanged, and there would be no recourse. Now we have other struggles. That struggle continues in other ways. Certainly the criminal justice system is heavily biased and racist, but we've made huge progress. But now there are many marginalized groups in our country. There is much hate. I was there, the trial of the second defendant in the killing of Matthew Shepard in Laramie, Wyoming. I've lived these things, folks, and I know that somehow we have to transform the pain of the non-resolution of these things into more love and more joy, as we have tonight. That doesn't mean that we can't bond ourselves together in sadness when we need to. We must, but we must also have our moments of triumph. Tonight is a wee triumph, because together, I feel, we have energized each other. I need it as much as you do. Because you may think I'm here as a source of energy for you. The truth of the matter is, this is very, very reciprocal. Here's the song Peter, Paul, and Mary sang that day. Please sing it together with me. With me. Oh, if I had a bell, I'd ring it in the morning, ring it in the evening.
Sing it out, danger. I'd sing it out a warning. I'd sing it out a But I still got a hammer, and I still got a band. Still got a song to sing all over this land. It's a battle of justice, it's a battle of freedom. So I've got a lot of the dreams, I've got a tendency to all over this land. Battle of justice. Song of love, the brothers and the sisters, all over this land, land, land.
Good luck. Have a wonderful, wonderful rest of a gathering, convention, meeting. I'm privileged to be with you. Now stand up and applaud all these kids. Let's hear it for Snoop. Snoop rocks.